Following the signing of a ceasefire between pro-Russian rebels and the Ukrainian government, Russian ambassador to the EU Vladimir Chizhov gives his analysis of the situation at the Euronews studio in Brussels.
Your Excellency, what's the position of your government vis-a-vis the ceasefire just announced? How can Russia help the ceasefire to be held?
I can only hope it holds. The problem with previous attempts was that, unfortunately, those who declared ceasefires did not deliver. Either they didn't really want it, but probably they were not able to. This is a problem that still remains, because some of the contingents fighting on the side of the Ukrainian government in the east are evidently not really accountable to the government. They are so-called private security battalions, financed and directed by Ukrainian oligarchs.
Russia always hoped or wanted to for NATO to keep its distance from the region and from its borders. Now, the situation has created the necessity for NATO to establish itself in the region.
I would put it in a different way. The situation in Ukraine has probably created a pretext for NATO to proceed along this course. The situation has given the alliance a lease of life, which is it doesn't really deserve.
The episode with Crimea, now the episode with the tensions and crisis in Ukraine, is not going to help the situation at all. I mean, you can't expect Europe to say, well, fine, yes, take here Crimea, take Eastern Europe, Eastern Ukraine, and we are just sitting and watching.
Crimea is a unique situation. It was a historical aberration rectified. We are not addressing any other situation in Europe or elsewhere which would be identical to the one in Crimea.